Now, it was the moment they fought for all season, and last night on the challenge, the final contestants had to race along 100 kilometres of Argentinian countryside to win the ultimate title of winners of the Challenge Australia.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my God, I'm so glad.
And the winners of the Challenge Australia are Troy and Kiki! Kiki and Troy, congratulations. You now qualify for your spot in the ultimate challenge competition. The first ever Challenge World Championship.
I think that both Troy and myself are such great testaments of the Australian spirit, and we are gonna give it our all at Worlds. I cannot wait to be beside him when we do it. He is one of the best guys that I've ever met, and I'm so proud of us.
How good.
Oh, and Kiki and Troy became winners. And they join us live now.
There
Kiki
they go.
And Troy.
Give them a clap. Well done. So good.
Thanks, guys.
Baby. I'm actually so glad to finally meet you. I'm often mistaken for you in the street.
Amazing. So next time people see you in the street, you better be carrying 45 barrels. Otherwise, they're not going to mistake you for me anymore.
They're going to be like, good luck in the Ultimate Challenge. Like, thank you. Gorgeous. Anyway, very proud for both of you. You were up against Olympic athletes, survivor contestants. You are a makeup artist. And how exciting was it to hear that you won the women's title, mainly because you can break those stereotypes that you don't have to have a lifelong history of, you know, physical success in order to be a champion.
I mean, for me, deciding to go on the show was really daunting because I know myself, I have, in a monologue sometimes it tells me I can't do things simply because, as you know, women, sometimes we're told, you can't do that.
Yeah, we've been trained from a young age.
So I had to really just dig deep and block out that little voice in my head that wanted me to quit so many times and just remember my family, everyone I was trying to make proud back home, and finding out that I was the winner was so surreal.
Oh, it's awesome. Yeah, we've talked to a few contestants on it and they said the challenges were hard enough. The drama that came along with the show was quite difficult for them to go as well. But you showed your resilience as well because you had a really bad back during the thing at the moment as well, isn't it? I mean, how was your back? That would have been very challenging.
It was so hard because the injury I actually got with one of the first eliminations that I went into. So I dragged myself through challenge and elimination one after the other. And without having a lot of time to rest and recover, it was excruciating.
Wow.
Troy, your time was 20 minutes ahead of the second place. How does it feel to not only have won, but by a landslide?
Oh, look, it was a 24-hour race, so I don't know if 20 minutes was quite a landslide, but, yeah, it was a fair bit ahead. It feels great. Like, I just felt really good out there. Like, I was surprised my body could keep going after that elimination. I was all banged up and bruised and beaten, and I'm just glad that the final wasn't much longer, to be honest, because I don't know how long that body would have lasted.
Yeah, well, you competed on Ninja Warrior as well. How did they compare? Because Ninja Warrior is a tough show, huh?
Yeah, they're just they're very different. Like Ninja Warrior, I felt like you just got one life, and if you fall in, that's it. Whereas in the challenge, there was this social game, there was drama. Some of the challenges were just physically different, and I felt like it was just a totally different environment for me to be in. I felt out of sorts, but I managed to slot in there nicely, avoid all the drama and just be a physical threat in the house, which was nice, and eventually got thrown in because of it.
Well, you've plenty of money for physio now that you're out of there. You're both $100,000 richer. How's this kind of money going to change both your lives? Is that you, Troy?
It's got to be massive for me. I've just recently bought a house and, you know, to get that off the mortgage and renovate and hopefully travel the world with my beautiful girlfriend. You know, I've been away a long time and she deserves, to spend some time with me too. So I'll probably, hopefully travel with her as well.
That's wonderful. Fantastic. Kiki, just before we go, I do want to ask you, what I adore about you is when you come from a franchise of reality TV, there is an expectation of you from society. And what I love about you is that you crushed that stereotype.
Thank you so much.
You killed it in one of the most hardest challenges on TV at the moment.
Absolutely.
For every young girl that is sitting at home, it doesn't matter if you break the box, if you're good looking or if you're not good, you're still breaking that box.
That's right.
What do you say to the girls at home who have an expectation of what they're being told they're capable of and what they should do?
one thing is the only person's approval that we need is our own. Mm-hmm. And I literally stuck it out and I told myself every single day, the little girl that used to be me telling myself, I can't do these things. That was who I did it for, and for my mum and for all these girls out there as well. So if there's something they set their mind to, absolutely go out there and grab it.
I love that.
Oh, that's fantastic. Good on you. I know you're going to take on the World Championships.
Absolutely.
Yeah. How are you feeling?
I'm going to hopefully make everyone proud of me. I'm going to dig deep and you're going to see a lot more makeup looks, long lashes, complaining, whinging. You know, I've got it all to keep you guys entertained.
You're fantastic. Keep that up. And Troy, you're awesome too, mate. Yeah. Enjoy those travels too. The Challenge World Championships is coming soon to Paramount+. Kiki and Troy, congratulations. Thanks for joining
Thank
us today.
Much.